morning. My name is Pam D'Angelo. I'm a kindergarten teacher here at Vicky Soto School. And today I want to talk to you about shared reading. Shared reading is a component of the literacy block. It's one component where all of the students and the teachers are reading one book. So we share one book, and as we progress through a five-day plan, the students acquire the language and the words of the book, so that it's really a shared reading and we're reading it all together. So I want to talk to you about how I go about planning for a shared reading before we even start. So I have a template that I use. This was given to us by the Columbia College, Teachers College, and it's used district-wide. And so it's a five-day plan. So there's 5 days to the shared reading. You're reading the same book for all of the 5 days. The first day is really just falling in love with the book. And so the components of the lesson are a warm-up. So you want to get all of them, their eyes warmed up to reading. So you might do something like a poem. Today I'm going to start with reading over our superpowers and then quickly going through our snap words because this book lends to having a lot of snap words that they need to know. So that kind of gets them warmed up and focused on what we're going to be doing. And it's only about 1 to 2 minutes. The next section of the lesson is a book introduction. And so I want to talk a little bit about the book and what they're going to be reading about today. So that's the way you start each book. The next portion of the lesson is then we read it together. And as we read the book, we stop, and I have already put in pre-set up post-its to remind myself as I'm teaching of what I want the students to do. I want to remind them to activate their prior knowledge. I want to ask them some questions and set up before reading. And then as they're reading, I've chosen some words that I think might be tricky words. And so I tell them to activate their superpowers because they're going to need those for some of these tricky words. And so I've covered a word, and we talk about using some of their strategies, their superpowers, and they're checking for understanding and reading to help them with these tricky words. And I just went through the book and chose some words that weren't super easy but lent themselves to either a picture power or they needed to use a combination of sound and picture power to figure out that tricky word. And then we continue through the book. And then at the end of the story, there's always an after reading to talk about what was that book about. It could be a whole group talk. It could be a turn and talk. Today I'm choosing to use a turn and talk method where they'll turn and talk to a partner and talk about some things that they remember about the story. It kind of just culminates and revisits what happened in that story. As I go through my planning, I usually sit on a Sunday and plan for the week for each of the 5 days. And what I do is, as well as thinking about what do I want to teach them, I plan out my post-its. And I just stick them on that day's plan so that I have them available to me for each day's lesson. And then these post-its can be used also on other books. So they're kind of generic posters, post-its that you would use. It says activate your snap word power, turn and talk with a partner, tell a partner. I have some punctuation that I'll be doing this book. Each book is kind of different. The previous book that I just did lent itself on day three is vocabulary. And so that day, the previous book that I just did lent itself to some vocabulary like the word walk and the word wrench. This particular book you're going to see me do more of a focus on sight words that they haven't learned yet, because the sight words that they're finding in this book, which is a level D, is a little bit more tricky. I chose a D. Most of my students are in the C range. A shared reading level should be 1 to 2 levels above where the children are reading at in that class, the majority of the students. I chose a D for today. There were a lot of new sight words that they haven't learned yet that we will be going over in this book. And at the end, we always, on the last day, we talk about fluency. Day 4 and day 5, as you're coming toward the end of the book, could kind of be collapsed at times. Sometimes day 5 might just be really just a run through of smooth read with the children, because by day 5 they really are getting the hang of the words and the language in the book. Day 4 I like to use as fluency. A lot of times at this level the children are still reading in a very methodical, robotic way, and so today or this week we'll be doing some scooping. So that the children can scoop words together and get that fluent feeling to their reading, like they're talking, as well as attending to punctuation. So if we have a question mark, this book does come up with some question marks and some exclamation points. So we need to teach them that they need to change their voice when they come to a question mark, or they need to either act excited or angry depending on what's happening in the story. And we'll have talked about that previously. So when we get to the fluency day, they really kind of know when they come to those different kind of punctuation marks what they need to do with their voice and their expression to correctly and fluently read that story. Okay, so we can talk a little bit about after the lesson, how it went and what you saw. So today was a good start for a share reading. We are going to read a new story called Buddy's Bath. Okay, Buddy's Bath. But before we do that, we're going to get our eyes warmed up. And we're going to read our snap words. Are you ready? Everyone's eyes are here. Cece, your eyes are over here. Ready?
M-C, like you are, so in we put, over, do, say, look this way. Look again.
No.
Am he to me, my at the big
here
going up on go a can it I is.
Nice job.
I got a little confused.
It's okay. We really know our sight words now, which always help us when we're reading, right? We're also going to, just because it's so important for reading, we're going to go over our superpowers. Are you ready?
We are super readers. We have pointer power. We have picture power. We have sound power. We have persistence power. What do?
Never give up.
Good. We have partner power. We have snap word power. We're really good at that. We have reread power. And we have, what's that? Pattern.
Change.
Right.
So there's our superpowers. So now that we're all warmed up, we know our sight words, we know our superpowers. You're going to like this book because you know what?
I just saw it up there.
Everyone loves dogs. Thumbs up if you love dogs. I love dogs.
I don't like dogs.
You like cats too? Okay. Everyone loves pets. Any kind of a pet. And this morning, if you notice, I asked you a question about dogs. I asked you the question in our morning message, do dogs like to take a bath? And some of you said yes, and some of you said no. So we're going to read a story. And the title of our story tonight is called Buddy's Bath. Buddy's Bath. So I asked you if you thought dogs like to take a bath, and it was kind of, we say 50-50. Some of you said yes, some of you said no. So we're going to see in this story if Buddy likes to take a bath. You're going to put it up there, yes.
So he's kind of happy to take a bath.
He does look like he's happy in that tub, doesn't he? So stop and think. Put your thinking caps on. Would we need to take a bath? Stefan?
We need shampoo.
Shampoo or soap?
I use soap on my hair.
Water. We will need
a face cloth. Do we use a face cloth on a dog though?
No.
Probably not. We probably wouldn't, but for us, we need a face cloth. Samara?
A towel
to dry them off later, yes.
Water.
Definitely water. Avery? Stephen?
Maybe a scrubbing brush.
What's he sitting in, Noah?
A bucket.
A bucket or a
bathtub.
A tub, right?
Bathtub.
A bathtub. Okay, so why do you think, look at where they are.
Why do you think you would give a dog a bath outside? What would be one reason? Think for a second before you talk. What would be, Erin, think about it, one reason you would give a dog a bath outside? Lydia?
Because maybe they could splash and they could...
Dogs aren't very neat like us, are they? They might make a big mess. So let's read Buddy's bath and see if Buddy, who is the name of our dog in the story, makes a big mess. And Buddy has two friends. This is Dawn. Say hi, Dawn. And this is Danny. Say hi, Danny. All right, are you ready to read? All right, so you're going to shift your bodies to our smart board. Now, before we read, we need to activate our superpowers. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Activate all those superpowers we just read about because we're going to need them. Stefan, right next to Samira. Okay. Honey, that way you're not in front of her. Good job. Okay, ready?
It was a very warm day.
I'm hot, said Danny. What can we do? Asked Dawn. Look at them. What season do you think it is?
Summer.
Stefan.
Summer.
Summer. Why do you say summer, Stefan?
Because summer gets hot.
It gets hot, right. It gets hot. So what else do you notice in that picture that would tell you it's summer?
They're sweating.
You can go out. Oh, raise your hand. You can go outside, you can go in the pool, okay, in the summertime.
They're sweating.
They're sweating, you can see they're sweating. Yeah. How are they dressed, Livia?
They're dressed short sleeves and shorts.
Short sleeves and short pants, yes. There's a question mark, absolutely. And you know what? We're gonna talk about that question mark, Jaden.
Today.
Nope, we're gonna talk about it on day three. So we're gonna put that question mark on day three. All right, we're going to talk about it. Today we're just kind of falling in love with this story. Okay?
We're not even in love with it.
Let's see. Not yet, but you will once you read it. We can give Buddy a bath, said Danny. What a good idea, said Dawn. So, Danny and Dawn, just sit and listen. So, Danny and Dawn went into the
house.
How did you know it was house? Give me a thumbs up. Go ahead.
Because I used my picture power and saw them opening the door.
Okay, so you used picture power. Let's take a little peek, just a little peek, to see if we're right. H.
House.
Does that match what you think?
Yes.
Did house make sense?
Yeah.
Let's see if it's house. Let's see if we're right.
House.
So Danny and Dawn, we're going to use our reread power, went into the house. You were right. It was house.
And
they came out with a big tub. They put it on the
ground.
What do you think it is, Lucas?
Grass.
Ground. What did you say, grass or ground?
Grass.
Grass? Who said ground? Someone, I heard ground.
Me.
You said ground?
And I said
me
grass.
Too.
I did.
What made you say grass, Lucas? How did you know?
Because there's grass on the floor.
Yes, they're outside and there's grass on the ground. So you're kind of both right because there's grass on the ground. Let's see. Let's look to see if we're...
Grass.
There's one of those blends we've been learning about. Grr. Say it. Grr. Does that sound like grass?
Yeah.
It also could sound like ground. I want you to give me a thumbs up if this word is grass.
Grass.
Thumbs up. How did you know, Caitlin?
Because there's a G and then I heard a S sound on...
Ah, oh, you read through the word, didn't you? So you knew because you read through because you knew what the ending sound was. So let's see what else happens. Then we got some soap. They put it in the tub. There they go, squeezing that soap. Then they got the hose. Can you see that? They put water in the tub. Dawn said, now we have a tub, soap and water. But we do not have Buddy, said Danny. Turn and talk. Tell your partner what you think is going to happen next. Quickly turn and talk. Turn and talk. Turn and talk. What do you think? What do you think is going to happen next? Right here, Jane.
I think 3, 2, 1.
Okay, so I need you to tell me, raise your hand if you want to tell me, what do you think is going to happen next? They're gonna find Buddy. Dawn said, come here, Buddy. Come here, Buddy. But Buddy ran away. Buddy ran away. Buddy did not stop. So Danny and Dawn ran too. They were chasing Buddy all over the yard. You need to get in the tub, said Danny. So Buddy
got into the tub.
What do you think? What do you think? Alexa.
He jumped.
Alexa thinks jumped. Would that make sense?
Yeah.
Jumped. Okay.
Yeah, because he splashed it.
Aha. So you're thinking he jumped because you see all those splashes. So that picture power helped you.
So that means he cannonballed.
Oh, maybe he cannonballed. Let's look.
Jump.
J, there's the J. Do you think it's jumped?
Yeah.
All right, let's see. So Buddy jumped in the tub. Stop, look, and listen.
Okay.
Quick turn and talk and tell your partner what you think is going to happen next.
Okay.
Three, two, one. Are you ready? Do you all think he's going to make a big splash?
Yes.
He's ready? Then they all got a bath. So not only did Buddy have a bath, but they all had a bath. Okay.
That's why he splashed.
So turn and talk. I'm sorry. Turn your bodies this way. Let's talk really quickly. What was the story? What happened in the story? Let's remember first what happened. First what happened? Stefan.
They were hot.
They were hot. And then what happened?
They put soap, water, and they used a tub and gave Buddy a bath.
Okay, hold on. Not quite yet. They were hot. And then what did they decide, Samara?
They decided to give Buddy a bath.
Sit on your bottom. Oh, no. Cece, what did they do after they decided to give him a bath?
He splashed it.
Did he splash yet? No. Not yet.
Jumped.
No, he didn't jump yet. They decided and they went to get
what? He ran around.
Well, what did they get first for his bath?
First they got
soap and
water.
And water and a bathtub. And then they had to do what? Stefan.
Get Buddy.
But Buddy did not want to participate.
Then he ran away.
He ran away. Yes, Cece, just remember to
raise your hand.
And Alexa, he ran away, but finally what happened?
He jumped into the bath.
Finally he decided he would cooperate and he jumped into the bath. And at the end of the story, Julia, what happened?
They all got a little water.
They all got a little wet, didn't they? Okay. So boys and girls, tomorrow we will read Buddy again and we're going to look at some of the other words in the story. Okay?
Not for tomorrow.
Did you like that? Thumbs up if you liked that story. I told you were going to like that because we all love dogs, don't we?
And dogs
are always a good story.
I don't like dogs.
Okay, so today's lesson was the day one lesson, and day one was falling in love with the book. Normally a lesson like that would run 8 to 10 minutes. Today it went a little bit over, about 14 minutes, and that's probably because it's day one and you're falling in love with the book. The book's getting a little bit more complex in comparison to what we've been using in kindergarten. In addition, I wanted to make sure that you clearly saw a lot of the components that we use in the shared read, so I wanted to make sure that I hit on those. So I was going a little bit slower just because I knew it was a teaching video. I want to share with you some of the things that happened today. The children noticed, as I was reading, one of the children noticed that there was a question mark. And one of the things I found was that kept happening as I first started doing shared reads. So I came up with a poster that I laminated, simple chart paper, and I just put the 5 days on. And if a child comes up with something, either a punctuation or sometimes it's a word, walk or wrench, that they might come up with, I put it on the day that's designated for that particular skill. So punctuation, language, word, vocabulary words would go on day 3. So when Jaden told me that pointed out that there was a question mark, I put it on day 3, and we'll talk about that on day 3 and how their voice needs to change, and I'll address that. And I found that that was the easiest thing for me. I wouldn't forget, especially the student that brought it up, and I can hold on to what the children were seeing in the book that wasn't getting touched, and I could put it on the correct day. And they're starting to learn which days actually we talk about words and punctuation. The process of day one is this, day two is that, and specific skills and ideas, the children are starting to pick that up. So now they know, okay, if we're going to talk about punctuation, it's going to be around Wednesday or day 3. And I just put, every Monday I put the new title of the book. Monday I just write, let's read, and if there's anything that comes up on Monday, I might write it. Otherwise, I'll put it on the other 3 days. It's just something, just a simple tool. Another tool that one of the other upper grade, first or second grade teachers designed was just this little card, and it just is a little grid telling you day one is this, day two is that, that you can leave to just glance at. I happen to have it up on my wall, and tomorrow when we go into the classroom, I'll just kind of point out the chart as I have it on my chart hanger, and another chart that's very similar to this, that if I get stuck, I can kind of just glance up and see when am I supposed to be talking about on that particular day. But you have your plan, so it's just kind of a double check. So day 2 was just falling in love. They had lots of questions. We did a lot of prior knowledge. I'm sorry, day 1 was a lot of prior knowledge, dogs, what do we need for a bath? You want to talk about that, so you kind of set up their idea, and so that they start thinking about words and tricky words that they might come across in the book. What do they need? Soap, they needed water, they needed a tub. And then where were they in the grass? So they really started thinking about the book and dogs and what might dogs do. So that's really what day 1 is all about, and just getting them to just to hear the book and kind of feel what the story is all about. So tomorrow's plan is MSV, meaning, structure, and visual. So we want to cue the children into does it sound right, does it look right, and does it make sense? Based on today's lesson, I think that they are cued into that, so we'll just go with the plan as is, and talking about how did they know, what did they use in their checking for reading, what did they use to help them figure out what those words were, did they use what it looks, did it look right, did it sound right, did it make sense, and I did ask them that a couple of times today as well, does that word make sense in the sentence, is that how you figured out what that word that was covered meant? So we'll move on with MSV for tomorrow.